Okay, I think program screen is not visible. So once again, I will open that program screen. You just chat and tell. Okay. Just a minute. So is the program screen visible now? So now you see, is it visible? Is program screen visible? Okay. So all the three programs once again I will execute. Okay, don't worry. I will execute all the three programs. So starting from the first program, I will execute. That is switch. Okay. So I hope for everyone the screen is visible now. So just concentrate on this screen. Okay. So trace into. Fine. This is the program control main function. Okay. So once I execute this complete program with F7 key, you just chat and tell. You have understood. Okay. With the program control concept. Okay. Clear. This is the clear screen. Then switch off 3. See here. You look into the program. 3 will be compared with case 2. So 3 is not equals to 2. So that particular statement is not executed. 3 will be compared with 5. So 3 is not equals to 5. That particular statement is not executed. 3 is compared with 3. So see out the word 3 that is executed. So 3 will be printed on the screen. The word 3 is printed on the screen. Okay. See here, program control will not go to the case 2 and check. So in this, wherever the program control is there, from there only it will check. So you should not think like it will go to the case 2, then it will check, and then it will go to the case 5, nothing like that. So at this particular point only, you are observing the program control in the switch statement, right? From there only it will compare. And when it compares from there, so it will come to know it has to go to the case 3 directly. Understood? So it will not go to the each case and test it here. You just observe the program control now, directly it will move to the case 3. See, you should not think that it is not compared. It is compared and the program control, it is moved to the case 3. Okay, fine. So because your statement is there, iostream.h header file will be executed. So these lines, we cannot understand, you leave as it is. Just you keep on pressing F7. Okay. See, so break statement is there. Okay. Because break statement is there, switch statement will end here. You see, it will come to the getch. Getch function is outside switch statement, so it will come to the getch. Okay. So the word 3 is printed. I hope everybody understood this program, right? Any doubts in this particular program? Okay, fine, no doubts. So we'll move to the next program now. So I think I have written some 5 to 6 programs on switch statement. So all the programs we will execute. Okay. So that we'll get an idea. Okay. And for every program, I will tell the explanation. You just listen to it. And in working of switch statement, whatever the explanations I do for each switch statement program, all the explanations are there in the working process of switch statement. So I will send the notes, you can read it. Okay. So in this particular program, the explanation is wherever the switch statement value matches, that is, you look at this line, switch of 3. Okay. Wherever this value matches, that particular case block is executed. And for that particular case block, break statement is there. So switch statement will end at that point. I hope you people got this statement. So wherever the case value, switch statement value matches with the case value, that particular block is executed, and break statement is there for that case block. So program control will come out of the loop, that is switch statement. Okay. Next. So next program I will execute, then I will tell you the explanation of that. Right. Okay, so this is the next program. Okay, so we'll execute this program. So C is equals to 10, that C value is substituted in the switch statement. Okay, you just remember this point. C is equals to 10, that C value is substituted in the switch statement. Okay, so we'll execute the program. C is equals to 10, clear screen. So here at this point, it is substituted. Okay, fine. Next, see. It has directly come to the default because C value is 10 and case values are 2, 5 and 3. Okay. So once again, I will tell you C value is 10 and case values are 2, 5 and 3. So 10 will not match with 2, 5 and 3 because 10 is not equals to 2, 10 is not equals to 5, 10 is not equals to 3. So here always it compares directly, direct comparison. Is 10 equals to 2? Is 10 equals to 5? Is 10 equals to 3? In that way, direct comparison. So exact value it should present, not greater than or less than, or greater than or equals to, or less than or equals to, exact value. If it doesn't find the exact value, it will move to the default. So here 10 is not equals to 2, it is not equals to 5, it is not equals to 3. So it is moving to the default. So the word default is printed. See here, two times I have written default. You just try to understand here. The thing is, this default, whatever it is appearing in white color, okay, without double quotes, this is a keyword with all letters in lowercase letters. This is a keyword. And whatever I have written in the cout statement, that is not a keyword. It is our own message. So what I can say here is default message, I can say. So that will not get confusion here. Okay. Default message, that is not a keyword. The word default is a keyword. Okay. So once again, I will execute. We just observe here. Okay. Fine. See, for this explanation here is, if the switch statement value doesn't match with any of the case values, if the switch statement value doesn't match with any of the case values, default statement is executed. Okay. If the switch statement value doesn't match with any of the case values, default block is executed. So we will move to the next program. Okay, this is the program. So in this program, what I have done, I have taken the variable name as choice. Okay. So here, whatever the variable you take, that variable name you give in the switch statement. Okay. And that value is substituted here. The value of choice is 5. So in this particular statement, switch of choice here, 5 is substituted. Okay. When it substitutes the value 5, you just observe. Okay. You just observe. Case values are 2, 5, 3, 7 and one default statement I have written. So it compares by checking with the first case value. Okay. So 5 is compared with the 2. So it will not match. So that particular statement is not executed. And again, 5 is compared with 5. So that is this particular statement is executed. When 5 compares with 5, when it is equal, this particular statement is executed. And because there is no break, so it will not end. So break statement is not there. Just a minute. So break statement is not there, it will not end. So the word 3 is also printed. Okay, that is case 3 is also executed. And again, there is no break statement. The word 7 is also printed. That is case 7 is also executed. And for case 7, there is a break. It will come out of the switch statement structure. Okay, so that I will show you by executing the program. See, main function is executed. Choice. Okay, so choice value is substituted here, 5. So 5 is compared with the 2. It doesn't match. It compares with 5. It matches, the word 5 is printed, there is no break, move to the next case, okay. Move to the next case, again there is no break, so move to the next case. Okay, so it prints a 7, there is a break, it will come out of the switch statement, okay. So now 3, 5, 3 and 7, three words are printed. because there was no break statement. So for this program, what we can understand is switch statement will end whenever break statement is encountered. Okay, or it moves to the till to the end of the switch statement. Okay, so whenever break statement is encountered, it will end. Switch statement will end. If there is no break statement, the program control will move to the next case. Okay, till it finds the break statement. Okay, now we'll go for the just a minute. Next program. Okay. Okay. So here I have to add header files. Okay, so in this program, value of C is 5, and see the difference between previous program and this program is, in the previous program I have written break at this point, that is at case 7, but here I have not written break statement at all. So what happens is, if there is no break statement in the switch statement, it executes till it reaches the end of the switch statement. Okay, once again I'll tell you, if there is no break statement in the switch statement, it executes till it reaches the end of the switch statement. So end of the switch statement here is default. Default is the end. After that, no statements are there. So you just see it compares with case 5, it matches, then there is no break, so it will move to the case 3. There is no break, it will move to the case 7. There is no break, it will move to the default. That is the end. So there it will stop. Okay, we will execute this program. So that means case break statement is optional in the switch. From that we can understand. See, 5. C value is 5. It compares with 2. It doesn't match. It compares with 5. It matches. 5 is printed. There is no break. Move to the next case. Okay. Move to the next case. There is no break. Again move to the next case. Okay. There is no break. Again move to the next case. So after default, if you write break or if you don't write break, both are same, because that is the end. Always default block is the end of the switch statement. If you write, it is the end. If you don't write also, last case statement will be the end of the switch statement. Default statement is optional actually. If you write, it is the end. So it comes out of the loop. See here. Okay, you just look at the output. 5, 3, 7 and default, all the things are printed because there is no break statement. So whenever there is no break statement, okay, it moves to the end of the switch statement. Okay, fine. Now last program we will execute. I think okay. So we'll execute this program and we'll stop the class. Okay. So in this program, the explanation is, first I'll tell the explanation. So if the switch statement value doesn't match with any of the case labels, and if there is no break statement also, and if there is no default statement also, what happens? Okay, that is the point here. So here you see C value is 10. Okay, this C value is substituted in the switch statement. Okay, and you see the case values 2, 5, 3 and 7. Four things are there. So 10 is not equal to 2, 10 is not equals to 5, 10 is not equals to 3, 10 is not equals to 7. Okay, so it is not matching with any of the case values. And default statement is also not there. And there is no break statement also. That means default is not there, break statement is not there, and case values are not equal to the switch expression value. What happens? Nothing will happen in the switch. That means no lines are executed in the switch statement. None of the lines are executed in the switch statement. Program is not wrong. But according to the program what we have written, no statements are executed in the switch statement. So we will execute this program and we will see. Just look at the program execution. One error is there. Sorry, here actually it is a C language statement. I will change it to C++. Okay. See, main function. Okay. Here the value 10 is substituted. I will tell this, you just listen carefully. 10 is not equals to 2, 10 is not equals to 5, 10 is not equals to 3, 10 is not equals to 7. So again, one more time I will tell you, program control will not move to the case 2 or case 5 or case 3 or case 7 and check. In this if statement only it will check. There only it will decide. Okay. That means it is not matching with any of the case values and there is no default statement also. So simply that switch statement is skipped. You just see here. Directly come out. Okay, outside switch. I have written the wordings outside switch just for your understanding purpose. So it will come out of the switch statement. Okay. See, the statement is outside switch. Okay. So one more time I will execute. Just look into the tracing part. Main function C is equals to 10. Clear screen. Switch off C means switch off 10. 10 is not equals to 2. 10 is not equals to 5. 10 is not equals to 3. 10 is not equals to 7. There is no default. So it will come out directly from the switch statement. Okay. I hope people got all these programs. With the further topics, we will look into the next class.